well-known old colonial hotel, also named Selecta. Now, this is a map of East Java, the most eastern part. To the left, you see Malang. Tomorrow, I'll travel via Lamajang to Jember, and then up to Bondowoso, where there will be some bullfighting in early September. By the way, not like in Spain, more harmless. And I'll try to visit the Lien Plateau, the crater up there. It will be a day trip up, then back to Jember, probably, and then down around to the southern corner where there is a game park, and then up to Bayanwangi, and in Kempang, they cross over to Bali, which is can to be seen on the right, that is Bali. So there is the ferry boat. So that is now what I hope to do in the next few days. Well, this is the old days Selecta swimming pool. Look at this gliding thing, a rutschbaan. It's a rather large pool and pretty old actually. Pre-independence it seems. There is also a kind of whip stellage. And there is a nice building on the other side with lots of flowers. Let us try to get them a little bit closer. Oh, we're trying to focus now. And a nice garden surrounding the pool. Just to film now those trees, which are very long and narrow. It is not very warm here, about 23 centigrade. Cool and nice in the hills. In the garden here, this beautiful hotel near Kalibaru, there's a bat hanging in the tree. He is sleeping here. Look at this, he's putting out his wings. He's now moving about a little bit. This garden is full of beautiful flowers, which I hope to show you. And later on we will be off to a plantation. Try to make a bit of a show of that. And he's giving off a show. See if we can get him here. Yeah, the head. The head of the bat. It's like a bit of a fuchs. He's a bit focus. Look at him again trying this. See now? We can get him. He's giving a show. It's a bit. Hang on a second. Yeah, there he is now. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So now you can see one of the wings. One of the wings hanging down. That should be it then. Maybe it is a so-called flying dog. We are not 100% sure. Spitting he is. There are a lot of beautiful flowers in this garden. Like this tree with pink flowers. I don't know the name of those. And those. And those. And those. And also those. Those one. Bit of an overview, just a few pictures, a few shots of the garden. It's a very lush garden, there's lots of trees and flowers and plants.
Mooi,
nee? Ja, mooie bloemen.
Ja, een vlinder, toevallig
daar. We have now reached the plantation near Kalibaru and this lady is busy to sort out the cacao beans, it seems.
Dus dat maakt los van deze. Van hier, van deze. Dat noem je daar. Waar ze de pitten vast aan zitten.
De cacaobonen zitten. Zijn die witte dingetjes?
Ja.
Een strong smell. Ja. Een sterke lucht.
Is gerucht, dat is. Het bevat alles dat. Alcohol, cacao.
Toch, ja.
Ja.
Apparently, this is an example of the cacao fruit. And here we have some cacao fruits hanging on the tree. Cacao vruchten die aan de boom hangen. And this is a small view of the cacao plantation. Another view of some cacao peaks.
Chocolade heet.
Cacao pitten. A bit further on we have a large tree. I follow the tree now, the branches, and to the right, what you see here, and I get it a bit closer, are fruits for to make kapok, to put in mattresses and things. Now they are white fruits. And I get them out as a long stick and a ladder. This is a waringi tree in the far distance. It's a beautiful example. There are often roots. Maybe you can see them after having zoomed it in. Dus ze moeten 's morgens vroeg hier al naartoe?
Ja, hier vroeg moeten ze beginnen te tappen en eindigen om 9:30. Vanwege als het warm begint, dan wordt het een stalt uit.
We gaan stollen.
De rubber, taking of the rubber from the tree.
En tap 400 komen per dag.
Hij komt bij de boom,
103,
snijdt de kerf en start en begint met tappen.
Ja.
Of gaat hij dan, hangt hij bakje onder, loopt hij verder en haalt hij staat water op?
Hier, zie je, hij vloeit al, hè.
Ja. Hij vloeit al?
Ja. Dus hij tappen, dus 400 bomen per dag. En zo'n boom, die mag, een rubberboom, mag niet aan één stuk door getapt worden.
Nee,
dat moet
niet.
Je moet minstens een rustpoging hebben van 2 dagen. Dus de tap geweest is zo. Maandag is het A, dinsdag is B, woensdag is C en komen ze donderdag weer bij A. Dit is het voor de natuurjager.
Dit is een row of rubber trees.
En een rubberboom, als men begint te planten tot hij zijn productie,
dus op een hoogte
van 1 meter, een stamomtrek van 40 centimeter, dat is die verstapbaar. Dit is een grote fabriek, waar ik aan kan zien,
dus ik zie de rubber
running. De hoogte tap en de roer hebben ze dat, ja.
Some men coming on the plantation. Bicycles.
Ja, dat wel. Nee, dat. Een oudste boom, 5-6 jaar mee.
Coffee tree.
En de water die ik heb, is rood, ja. Een rode coffee tree. Hier staat die groet al omhoog.
A tree with coffee beans.
Nee.
A view over the coffee trees.
Zoetig geur.
Coffee trees.
Zoetig smaak.
An impression of the plantation from the other side. Just before I filmed some more rubber trees on the other side of the road, but this is the coffee situation. Coffee trees, coffee struiken. At this point we see the rubber, the latex in the containers, and each container apparently is the content of taking rubber from 400 trees. It is still very soft stuff. A nice view of the rubber trees in the distance. Somebody walking. Here an example of latex running down from the tree into the little container. Het opvangbakje. Hopla. Hier ziet goed de witte lijn van de latex die boven over de rand van de boombast loopt. These ladies are sorting out the coffee beans. And I put the green ones away in a separate spot. Waar gaan ze aan, ja? Now another bags with coffee all lying around here. This is a small collection of green beans separated from the red ones. People busy with the coffee. On the distance to the right is our guide who explains to us in Dutch what goes on here. Now we are at the factory area of this plantation. Just a few buildings you can see. Garden-like setups. Those are the containers to ferment the cacao, white cacao things you have seen the women before preparing, and after fermenting you can separate the meat from the pits. The pits are used apparently to make the cacao. So after fermenting, those are the pits to make the cacao. The equipment to wash and clean the pits. And after washing, they are transported to this area. I call them cacao pits. They're probably cacao bonen or cacao beans. And here they have to stay for 7 hours in the sun to dry. Those dark ones apparently are of inferior quality because they have those dark ones, to repeat it again, have apparently been infected by insects and are of inferior quality. So here we find the brown ones, which are apparently the right ones, the good ones. Look at the long stretches of them.
Finally, they are done. Inferior quality cacao. They go like this to Europe to be processed further.
Because now
numbers of the good quality cacao
and
inferior cacao.
We have now reached the coffee factory.
However, we are here suddenly now in the rubber factory.
now looking into a drying room for the latex. Temperature about 40, 45 degrees, I would believe. Very old buildings. Before the war, that must have been all constructed. The drying rooms for the latex. Takes 5 days. The heating is still done in a very primitive way, just by burning wood. Below the heating chamber, this is. This machine, because of the steel, although I go after washing, and smell every quarter. I do not know how this process is done. Here the steel is dropping goes down. For instance, this is the remainder of the steel cell is killed. Take this water. Apparently there is sorting of the coffee. In the distances we see a lot of wood for heating the ovens. Here is a happy group of sorters together. Foto.
Ada bingin.
Yeah. The visitors and the sorters. Coffee sorters. The girls working with the coffee. Yeah. She's setting it out apparently with their hands. There we are. Final coffee, first quality, ready to be packed. Sitting here together to sort the coffee. See what dametjes, some ladies. Filmmakers are working here. To the latex, we have here apparently smoked latex, brownish color, ready for export. They are cleaning the latex with a brush. Latex, apparently. And then finally, packed and ready for export. Here is some information on the ripped smoked sheets, written on the wall. Contaminating is written there. Last glimpse of the premises before we are going for coffee and then home to the Arbor Hotel. An old colonial factory apparently, 1928-1930. We are now on the way up to the Gen Plateau. We are fairly high up here. Last bit to go by car about half an hour, then by foot onwards. Just give you a view of the surroundings. A bit more close up.
There are cars coming down all the time with people. Lars is going down to the valley probably. Another one here going down. They all look a bit excited at me. We are now climbing towards the walking towards the Gen Plateau, or we are maybe already there. And from this point where the carriers of the Zwavel are starting their trip down 70 kilometers, I have an opportunity to film this view. Once again is zooming, and now you see this crater here, the crater edge in the far distance. Well guys, there you are, happily together. My companions on this walk. What you see here is the crater edge, the slope. It starts in the beginning a bit on the, at a small angle, and then it goes steeper and steeper. This is the Iron Crater, coming in a minute. So it goes up and up, higher and higher. This is all the edges of the actual crater. And then when I now go down here, then in a minute, you will see the actual crater there. And some of the kind of smoke coming out. The people you see walking are people carrying in baskets yellow stuff called in Dutch zwavel. And they carry it from a collecting place down at the lake. We are coming to a lake there. Down all the way about 17 kilometers. They carry maximum 50 kilos and get for each kilo 125 rupees, which is about 10 cents, Dutch cents. Some lava droppings, sorry, some zwavel droppings, which they lose when transporting it, carrying it. This is a fantastic view. We left this morning the hotel at 4 o'clock, arrived at the end of the road at 8 o'clock, climbed up to 2,800 meters, and are now actually at the crater. Now down here is a lake of extreme beauty, the well-known Eigen Crater Lake. And the color is very remarkable. I see it black and white in the camera. I hope you will see it in a beautiful color as it is. Turquoise, I believe it is. Caused by the zwavel. It is, well, another view of the lake. We will make a few more shots in it in a moment. My companions in front of the lake. Let's get them a bit closer. Nice silhouette, I believe. A zwavel carrier. Now this is not so easy to film. There is a peculiar light fall in there. But we have here the crater still. And the lake. Now you see the lake there. The end of it. And then here is a lot of smoke and dust, which makes it difficult to photograph, to film too. However, there in the far distance, you can see the zwavel collectors. Now I get them now in focus, and even more in focus, you can maybe see some of the movements there, and that it is yellow. That is the end. That's what I can do for you. Beautiful is also the crater slope, which I now will follow down. Very nice one. Once again, 2,800 meters, a fresh wind here, not too cold. These collectors of zwavel are coming all the way up from the lower part, along a pass up to here, and then they follow up the road up along the crater edge to the pass down to the village, to the town where they deliver it, 17 kilometers. Maybe you can see them moving there in the distance. I believe there is one walking down there. Another shot of this fantastic view. Sitting here at the edge of the crater, and there are many flowers. You won't believe it. I try now to get them in the zoom. Yeah, focus. Small little flowers growing in the lava fields, which is most amazing. Then maybe I can show you, because the lava is just there. And you can see the some parts of it, the edges of it. Look at these bits of lava, and that goes down all the way down the crater slope, the inset crater slope into the lake. Focus. Also some lava on that side. It's all like that. And carrying the sulfur. And this man carries about 40, 50 kilos, and he has to go all the way down to the town to deliver it there.
Dolphins here, we're hoping to see them. Over the island of Java in the distance. This is the interesting thing about tourism. All these people in boats looking for dolphins in the early morning. These animals can't just swim alone in peace.
Just a few shots of Bali near the coast in the north. Here the area looks very dry and has been eroded for some reason. This offers a little bit of a better view. This is the place where I first stayed on Bali. It's called Permata Cottages. In the distance the sea. There are some nice little houses here to live in. Very cheap, about 10,000 rupees, about 8 guilders a night. And the beach, which is not a very large one, and the sand is a bit dark. But it is still a nice place. The water is not very deep though, to swim. Those boats took me to the dolphins yesterday. And the cozy little restaurant attached to this lodging place. Those are the more expensive cottages, which have air conditioning.
Bedel.
Hallo baby.
Bedel.
Hallo. Hallo.
Hallo.
Hallo. Hallo. From the coast we are now driving up towards the Batur volcano. And this picture allows you to see some of the lower parts where we are climbing up. We are climbing the crater edge, the slope. And you can see the slope here, going up. Just a picture of this area. We are now getting higher and higher. And as you see, there is a lot of forest here and villages. And we are trying to get to the crater rim in a minute. There is some interesting growth there. It's kind of plants on this rim. The road is creeping up towards the crater rim. In the far distance, the sea. So we are climbing more and more. I'll just give you a view of the round shot of this area. Somewhere we meet many flowers. And some villages in the distance. Trees, and forest. The way we meet many children. They are coming from the school. Those are not running away. It is Rena with them. We are now getting to the top. Look at this symbol in there, which is not the one we like so much. It is a Hindu symbol. You find it on many temples and many places. Now we have the look down over the forests and the villages and even a temple area down there. So this is quite nice. Now let us have a look closer to this temple. There it is. Where is parts of it? And then to the next, the village. Yeah, it's the common ground there in the village. People gather. The gate to enter the temple. And next to it you can follow the further slopes. You see going up and up and up. Amazing is also the beauty of the flowers you find a lot over here. And the other side shows the clouds hanging over the volcanoes and mountains. Flowers again. Another view from this rim here. Children walking from the school, the little village. So at the other side of the summit, on the other side, we have now this beautiful view of Lake Batur and the crater Batur. Is it the crater too? Yeah. From this point we can see the lake better. Lake Batur, just behind the tree there. Let's get it closer. See now. Rena, now the real one I'm filming now is the Agun.
No, the Batur one.
The Batur, is that the Batur?
Batur Pus.
Yeah.
And the second is Abang.
Abang.
And the last with the shadow of Cloudy. You see?
Yeah, so this is Batur, this is Agang, and the last one is Agung.
Agung, and the down is the lake of Batur.
And the Agung is still alive, still active.
Yeah.
He has done a lot of...
On Agus.
This is another nice shot, a bit nearer, with the Agung in the background. And there are the two other volcanoes.
Still,
this Batur crater is one within a large crater. So it is a volcano within a large crater. You can see the rims on the side here running around. You see? There. This is another nice view of the Batur volcano. You can there see the lava so well down in the lower slopes. Lava here. This is a small interval from the previous. What I show you now in this bit is the place where I stayed 1.5 years ago, Air Sani. There is here, in the place called Puri Sani, a cold water, freshwater swimming pool of extreme beauty and freshwater. And on the background is the sea. In the background is the sea. Many flowers. It is a nice garden here. Nice garden. The entry building. View of the top of it. See the typical crater rim. And the next one, the top, same thing. Batur. And that beautiful lake. Batur crater lake. See the rim of the old crater here. And then we go back to where I've been before. The lava and the other one. And this is a beautiful view because we are now reaching the edge of the lake. There is a lot of agricultural work being done. Here you see those little vegetable gardens. Nice picture. Peeping out the edge, from the edge of the old crater rim. And terraces have been built on the inside of the crater.
The place is very good people, but yeah. It's not expensive.
And you? Yeah? Yeah, sir.
It's very nice here. Look for the monkey hood.
Where is it better? It's not really in focus now. Now, you don't like this here? My brother Hans would enjoy to see the vegetable gardens around this lake shore. I think this is cabbage, right? And there again we have the craters. See now this wonderful constructions and openings to slow the lava out, and there are huge lava blocks lying down there, apparently. Huge lava blocks, like those. And next to the coal field, coal means the vegetable, there is suddenly a ceremony going on. A Bali ceremony on the lake shore, which I now try to show you. Now this major bit, try to bring it a bit closer to you. This group is making music. Now look at this stuff. Big, large instruments. Offerande, offering something. And all this next to huge cabbage fields. Vegetables. Cabbage, whatever. I'll put it again for you because it's so nice. This is fully zoomed in, so it's a fairly large distance. all this on the shore of this beautiful lake, within the crater, the old crater. Once again, all these colorful things down there. And there they are. We have just given these ladies a lift for a few kilometers. We are now more or less on the foot of the craters, the Dumba Tour. And what you see here are all the remnants of destroyed villages, destroyed houses. This has probably been destroyed by a stream of lava. Here a bit of a close-up from lava stones. The lava is everywhere. Around us, back in the rear of the lake. This is a lot of the stain, as it were. Bumped into a ceremony coming home. Just now, at the same moment, I want to go up there. And I am happy to be able to just to film this. It is the apparently the preparation for tomorrow. Just now. Probably going to the temple. Where is this? Tomorrow. Typical Balinese shows us. Very typical. Still heavy music in the distance. Voila, more coming. So let's speak. That's it. Once again, the place where I stayed 1.5 years ago. Here is the garden, which is very beautiful, and this cold water swimming pool, fresh water, and in the background the sea. Here they have lots of beautiful flowers. It is a very beautiful garden. There's a lot of flowers and trees around, all tropical. This is the cottage I stayed before. One of the flowers in the garden. I don't know the name. And even here, flowers everywhere. Cacti. This is all very nicely played out. We once had a ceremony here 1.5 years ago behind this little building. The most peculiar types of flowers and plants you find here. Coconuts on the tree and lying on the floor to be used later. I hope I said the right thing though about them. With some water ladies there. Hello? Hello? Once again, without backlight. Hello? 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 Mr. Ernest.
Yeah. Come here.
No, I don't. No, I'm
small group of people I know in this place. They are building a protective wall here to protect the garden from the sea, and all the work is done by manual labor by hand from the early morning 8 o'clock till the evening 10 o'clock. Hard work, little money. Just to give you an impression of this. A lot more. See, they are cutting the stones, there's hammers, and there's the machine to make the concrete cement molen. Hard work. Now this shop has been taken at the place where I'm staying at the moment. It's my host, Rena, and his dear wife and little child waving to us. Yes, she's waving. I'll get it a little bit closer. You may remember her from my previous shot. Yeah, the duck and the geese. Hallo, Putu. Hallo. Thank you.
Oh, and yes. Back is Gamlan here.
You mean we go first to the road? Are you going to walk in the procession?
Yeah, we just in the back.
In the back, yeah.
That way you must in the first and then thread like this. The white thing. They use everything.
Let us do that, yeah.
Thank you.
Now we have this ceremony coming. Going to the temple. I've been dressed as a Balinese as well. I will be going to join them in a minute. So the music has passed. It's a long group. So I will long. We will probably walk behind and join them in a minute. So I'll now stop it, this show. I feel very strange like this though. There is more coming.
Yeah. Not only the bigger some fruit and then the fresh in the
Okay. They have now come to the shore and I film this with backlight because there's a lot of light against. They're all here together. There. I don't know what will happen. We'll see in a minute. It looks like a kind of market now. People are waiting, eating, standing here. But I have no clue what will happen. No clue what will happen. Not a clue. Here you see the offerings which my good friend Rena and his wife took along. Maybe we can put it a bit more in the bit close-up. Yes, all this. And what are you going to do with it, Rena? What are you going to do with it?
This?
Yeah.
Over there in the bit.
Oh, yeah. There is a suckling pig there on the tree, on the car. Which is what they later will go eat, apparently, cut in pieces. Now let us have a look again here.
probably putting all the offerings together. I still don't know what it's all about though. I tried to find out. You should put it all together here. This is a huge group of people. Meanwhile, some people are going in the sea to swim. The offerings are heating up here. These men are preparing the probably the gamelan music show, which is expected. I heard there will be some dancing too. Here, some gambling is going on apparently. Putting the bets, putting the bets. No cockfighting now.
Da kamen die Frauen gerade aus der Kirche, aus dem Tempel, den Berg runter.
The temple at which the ceremony is held. One priest is putting sticks of scent. A nice gate in the rear. Put him back a minute. You get that a bit closer. As well. Full zoom. This is the name of the temple. Now, difficult to read. Just hang on a minute. The question is now, what is going to happen? Some kind of ceremony is going to happen. The priests are now doing the prescribed rituals. Now let us have a look again at the offerings there. And let us have a look again at the temple. Temple. Another statue. Colorful offerings. Likewise, lift up the hands. And there's some singing to hear, but I do not know where it's coming from. The rear, there you see the gamelan. Nice overview of the ceremony. The men in the rear, few men, women in front. Stops now, just finished. Now, starting again. Bit of gamelan music here. Cutting up some durian fruit. Let's try to eat one first. And now there have some dancers just on the beach. Sitting next to the pig, horse's pig, and here's the old man there, and the offerings are getting more and more. Apparently it is now starting again on this side, the religious ceremony. Same thing which happened in the temple before. Yes, you just put in the child down, I wanted to film that. Now going around with some holy water or something. Get down now. Nice to be gamelan with it. Nice piece of. in Europe is the Weiwater. So they are here spraying the people with other holy water. Let's go to the left again. From the other side I take this now. And on the beach, the little children are playing. Playing their little games. End of the party. Also the garden,
yeah.
Where I'm staying at the moment is very beautiful. There is the rented jeep in the background, and you see everywhere lots of flowers and plants,
yeah.
Tropical flowers.
Yeah.
Two of the guys working here, and you see this tree next to my cottage. Just another view in the garden. There is an abundance of flowers and plants. A pond with birds, geese, ducks. Voila, also not so bad. Voila. And in between those little yellow basin, little friends running around. And then there is this great view from the top down to the sea. That's the place where this work is done for making a wall, protective wall down there. And there are the children splashing in the sweet pool. This is the sweet water pool seen from above. There in the distance you see some of the work being done on the wall. And the lookout over the roofs towards the little jungle places. And the restaurant is here on top of the terrace. Background the sea. Plenty staff smiling at me. So 9:10 in the morning, and finally, as you see, there is flowers everywhere. Flowers everywhere. This is the den. We are pretty high up now, somewhere on the road between Singaraja and Tenpasar, and there's a side road leading again to Singaraja, and here we find this beautiful lake which I now show you. What name has the lake?
Buyan.
Buyan. Lake Buyan. Especially this end view. Look at the other side now, there is a lot of jungle. And a little bit further on, there is a second lake called Lake Tamligan, which also is a beautiful lake to watch. A lot of jungle in the distance. The other side looks very flat, and there are some boats lying there in the long far distance. You can even see the shape of a small temple there. on this little trip down again to the north, to the sea, northern sea, we make a stop in this lovely little garden. In the distance, we have this kind of forest. And this kind of very nice bungalows where you can stay. On the way down to the coast, we are now passing fields where rice is grown, sabas. This is a nice example of one of those. Just show you it. And now, much closer up, you can see how the individual plants are put in the water in the fields. Just far away and close up. And a general view of the surrounding, inside a lot of clouds and a bit of rain. Here you can see the Sava irrigation. It's all on the water. So here they are underwater. Apparently there is not yet any rice in it. This is a beautiful view really. The terraces and the surroundings, and the village in the distance. It's now zoomed out, you can see the terraces more clearly, how they are laid up, then the village down there. And those terraces before the village, in front of. We are just in a family's home outside the city of Singaraja, Lovina, and the host has climbed a coconut tree to cut some out for us. He's upstairs now, he's not upstairs, he's good, yeah. He's sitting on the top. You see him in shade against the light, the evening light. They have some animals here walking around. He's still again doing that now. Maybe I should backlight. Just hang on a minute. Now there's the opa holding a baby. The baby is a bit scared. So he's just been up the tree and now he's coming down the tree. He does it just like that. It's not amazing, eh? I follow him all the way down. Now you can see the body better. Because of the light. So back on the back down. So now he's cutting the coconuts for use to drink them, eat them probably later. Marianne is cutting them. Cutting them into pieces. The papa is the child. The child has been prematurely born, and it's 6 months old. It's after 6 months. The mother. Okay. Yeah. Have the whole family together. Yeah. Now I zoom it in a bit. Yeah. Opa is the car. Yes. One happy friend here. And a lot of. And some friends there. And now also the mother has arrived with the child. Yes. They have these cocks in baskets. And he just took it out and now he is giving this cock a bit of treatment, probably for the purpose that it will have to fight later on somewhere here in this area. Ja? Can you lift it up a bit?
Nee, kan nog niet.
Ja. Ja, and turn it on the side.
Ja,
ja.
En
ja. You massage it a bit. Ja.
Oké, nou kan ik het je vertellen.
En Arnold. Ja.
Arnold.
Ja, ja.
Ernest.
Thank you. Ja.
Where you come from?
Now we are just going
for like. He's apparently very proud when she's on, no?
Yeah.
United. Yeah, now they sit all together. Yeah. Voilà, there you have the head of a fighting cock. And our friend will very soon start a fight with another one in a few minutes. This is a kind of mock fight, not with knives, and not certainly not meant that they kill each other, but it is just a mock fight between the two. And they kick them up a bit to make them aggressive, you see? You see that? See the hairs in the neck up? Ah, there is no knives on there, no blood. Also for the those who don't like it. Follows this. Oh! He doesn't know what happens. We are driving now along the north coast of Bali towards the east, and there is here a beautiful view of the Agung crater. This crater has had a horrible eruption in 1963, and we will later see lots of lava lying around. The whole area has been destroyed. We are turning away from the sea, so a last view of the crater. This is a river where the lava came through when the eruption happened, and from under the road the lava did stream through the riverbed into the sea. The guardian of the bridge. And here, further towards the south, we have this lovely view of Sawas, which I now will try to film over a distance of about 180 degrees. This is one bit, and this is the other bit. And there is also speculation. You can see the zoom. And here you can see how the little rice plants are put in the water. Here are also beautiful places where houses are situated. Situated on the slopes, overlooking the rice fields. And here you see a little bit of irrigation works, irrigation system. We have now tried to reach the crater Agung a bit closer. There is a road up, but not very, very far. So this is my last shot probably of this famous crater, famous volcano. It's a lush world of green all around. All around here. This shot shows you how the work is done in the fields. The workers, must be hard work, and they use animals also. You can see there. Devices to cut open the soil. nice shot, isn't it?
We are now at the most southwestern part of Bali, and there is a large temple complex here called Aluwatu. We'll have a look at it in a minute. On one side there is this fantastic cliff going down to the sea, and then you have the surfing, the waves, surfs. Again with some flowers in the foreground. Uluwatu. Look at the...
Are you happy? You see your brother and your sister? Where did you see me?
The temple entry is full of Hindu motifs. You will remember Ganesh. It's the elephant head. The left side Ganesh. Another motif on the second entrance gate. And another Ganesh. And on the other side, this beautiful coastline again. You hear the sea very well, maybe also in the microphone of this camera. Nice coastline though. South West Bali. And that is the last bit of the temple. Just the edge of the rocks, on the edge of the rocks. There are plenty of monkeys here, eating the food they get from the tourists. This is a fully fledged view of that gate at the end of the temple. Then from the other cliff, which I've just filmed, you see the temple from a distance. Cliff edge and the gate. Now we go down on the sea. The sea is, it's a rock formation nearby, but it's this one. No, here. Just a minute. Maybe it can be seen with the camera. The sea is very clear, and under it you see the corals appearing. The waves breaking on the cliff. So like that. On the way north again from Sanur, I found this very beautiful Sawa situation here, which I now would like to film for you. Beautiful terraces, really, that have been laid out. This is really something. And there suddenly in a village, I just meet a funeral pile, which is probably going to be used. And this is probably the access steps up, it seems to me. I can take this from very close. The people here are pleasant and not so pushing. Huge bamboo sticks to carry it. Just a detail picture. Just a detail picture. This has been made. Beautiful chance to film just now. This is another view where you can see the crater very close. First one, two craters, and then in the distance the lake. It's taken on a different day, a different time. There is a small walking path going there up to the crater rim. Just follow the crater rim again this time. Closer, more close up, you see. So this is a beautiful thing. The Varining tree with the roots around another tree and using it as a parasite. It's a huge one. It can hardly manage to put it all on film. Up, 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 up. So it is. No more distance. So it's about that. So. The roots are very thick. It is standing on the premises of an old temple. Apparently a temple which is not more in good shape. It is amazing display shows some destruction or use, wear and tear from the weather. This is a view of the old temple from the distance. Back in Sriracha, and you see the monument, the one about the battle against the Dutch, and then suddenly next to it, the red, white, blue flag. Most amazed I am. But down there, apparently they are shooting a gun. So that is what happens. I can't go there at the moment, it's closed off. But maybe they are killing somebody there, shooting somebody apparently. They have the guns, the pistols in their hand. You see that? That's all I can see so far. Shot, and now he will probably fall down. Clap, clap, clap. They used apparently the wrong spelling. Shooting is 1-0. These are the waterfalls of Gilgit. Gilgit, actually. On the way up to Denpasar from Sriracha. There are some local people bathing here, walking around near the falls. A closer up picture. And there is also a cold water pool where apparently many visitors and tourists are bathing, some of them at least. Again, lots of flowers here. Maybe you can recognize them. There is also a botanical garden on Bali, which I have reached here, 1200 meters high. It is a sister garden of the one in Bokor, and this is a beautiful entrance gate. You show the detail of it now. Some of the motifs, reliefs on the gate itself. Probably like lotus flowers, I presume. And from the rear side, elephants. The other side, monkey, antelope, cow. Just a view towards the entrance gate from inside. The botanical garden won't be easy to film. I just can make one or two pictures for you. Trees, trees, trees from the other side. Very quiet here, nice to walk. This could be an old Waringin tree here, which probably has swallowed up one parasited on it. It is an old one. Interesting example. It's a bit closer look up of the roots. Going down. There's a large one there too. It's a weird tree because it's branched off like that and then it goes down. Fast, fast, I do it, just to the ground. And near to it is a field of roses. It is certainly no Keukenhof here, but it is just a beautiful park. Do you know the name of those flowers? And those must be well known to you. One of the few larger groups of flowers in the park I've seen so far. One more in detail. They look like orchids. Those are well kept. The red ones look very poor, much poorer. It's poor state.
And again, accidentally, in the outskirts of Singaraja, I hit upon a future funeral ceremony setup. I have made that up today or yesterday. And it is in intriguing little construction. That's his top. That's going. So now I'm making a close-up of this. See the fine work, color work of all these parts. It's very nice. Was it your grandfather?
Yes.
For how long has he been dead?
About 20 years ago.
20 years ago?
20 years, yes.
Strange pictures here.
Okay, explain to me a little bit about it.
So, Army.
This is an attempt to film the sunset after sunset Stimmung at Lovina Beach. It's about 6:30 in the evening. Those lights are from the fishing ships, fishing boats. There should be some red, cloudy background there. Even so, at the hotel, Lovina Beach. We'll be right back.